And shining stars, welcome back to my channel, and welcome back to another monthly favorites. That's right, it's that time of the month again. Not that time of the month, but it's that time of the month again, where I get to show you what my favorites have been for this past month, and these are my August favorites, and I have a lot, so let's just get started. And by the way, these are just beauty favorites. I decided not to include TV, music, or books, because that would just make this video, like, 2 hours long. Anyway, let's get started. So the first thing in here, I don't have them on my nails right now. I'm actually putting them on later today. But are my Jamberry wraps. I absolutely love my Jamberry wraps. They are so amazing. I love them. I will leave the link down below to my consultant if you guys would like to check out the Jamberry wraps and maybe order some. Just check it out, click her link, and she will help you get whatever Jamberry wraps you need. And I have two highlighter favorites this month, and one of them is kind of also like a blush, but it's the Japanesque, I can read it on the bottom, Japanesque Liquid Light, and this is in the color 2, because one was white, and it showed up like nothing, and so I kind of went for the peachier toned one, and I actually really like it. It doubles as a blush for me, so it's really, really nice. It just gives a nice luminosity to the cheeks. And then, of course, what makeup beauty guru, makeup artist would I be if I did not have the Jaclyn Hill Becca Champagne Pop Highlighter? This stuff is very quickly become holy grail. It is beautiful on everyone I have tried it on, and it is just the most buttery. This is obviously the first Becca product I've ever owned. It is the butteriest, softest, most beautiful highlighter I have ever used. And you guys are in great luck because it is under the Sephora, like, art editor's picks or whatever, or something like that, where it's still available at Sephora right now. So if you guys want it, go, run, don't walk, quickly to the Sephora website and order it. Like, now. Not tomorrow. Now. Okay, moving on. Oh, wait, I had 3 highlighters. Okay, my third highlighter favorite is the Wild and Radiant Palette by BH Cosmetics. And it's got 2 highlighters and 2 bronzers. And they look just like that. And they are really, really pigmented. This is just the top 2. But, I mean, that's what they look like. I would swatch them, but I can't really lift my arm up to... Well, maybe I can hold it up. That's what they look like. I mean, they are super pigmented, and they are really, really nice. I really, really like them. Sadly, though, the mirror is broken. Speaking of BH Cosmetics, I've also fallen in love with their Galaxy Chic palette. I mean, I have created... One of my favorite looks that I created, I'll insert it right here, was with the reds in this palette, and it just made the prettiest eye. And this is what the doodad looks like. And it's called a palette, not a doodad. And it is just the most beautifully pigmented, let's see here, let's go with this one, and this one. Pigmented palette I've ever seen them come out with. I mean, this is what they look like. Isn't that beautiful? I mean, they're just so beautiful and so pigmented, and just, I love the marbling effect on them, and it's wonderful. Next thing that I've been loving is an oldie but a goodie, my Neutrogena makeup wipes. I was out of them for a while, and I didn't realize how much I loved them until I was out of them for a while, and then I was like, I need my Neutrogena makeup wipes back in my life. And next on the list, moving on from that, I was sent the Maybelline Superstay Better Skin Foundation for review by Influencer, and I actually wound up really, really liking the foundation. It's a light to medium coverage. it's really, really nice on the skin. It really did make my skin look better, not as red, not as splotchy, and I absolutely really, really loved it. It was a really good skin match, or a color match, and yeah, it was amazing. Next thing is I have, how many mascaras did I put in here? 1, 2, 3, 4, what was it? Did I only put 4 here? Alright, I'm rocking it. First one was my Mini Perversion by Urban Decay, which I already know I love because I bought the full size. I'm just using up my little ones first. And then I've had this for maybe about a month, or actually more about 2 months, the Colossal Volume Express, but I've really been using it this month, and it gives just a nice, natural, fluttery look to the eyelashes. And then I really love the Rimmel Scandalize Flex, which I know, oh my god, she's moved away from the Curve Alert, I know. But I love the Scandalize Flex. I think that it is just, it really gives you that volume and that length that you're looking for. And then I really actually like the Colossal Chaotic Lash, but not used as you're told to. It looks really, really nice when you just brush it up against your lashes, but I don't do the windshield wiper motion to, like, get them to clump together, because that's just not my thing. But as just a regular mascara, it's actually really quite nice, and I got this when I was at BeautyCon. Let's see. I have a concealer favorite, if I can get it out. Here we go. My concealer favorite is the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in number 10 Light, right? Yes, I got it right. This is actually probably going to be one of the first concealers I actually have to repurchase. I've never had to repurchase a concealer before because I've never liked one this much. And I love this, but I do want to try the Better Skin concealer as well. So, we'll see about that. And then since I have one in my hand, I'll just grab the second one. I really, really, really have been liking my Urban Decay Perversion eyeliner. I've been trying to use up Zero, and I just keep falling back onto this guy. And that's bad because I really need to use up Zero because I've had it for a long time. It's time for it to go bye-bye. But I want to use it up. I don't want to waste it. And it's not like it smells bad or anything. But, yeah. I love this eyeliner. It is the creamiest. Just, they make the best eyeliners. Urban Decay, hands down, makes the best pencil eyeliners. For high-end. And then, I've really been liking, I have a lot of, like, felt tip liquid eyeliners. And I've really been liking the Ico Skinny Liquid Eyeliner. I was really surprised because I didn't like the Ico mascara I tried, but I really, really like the eyeliner. It's really nice. It's super black. It creates a wonderful line, and I love it. It's great. It's fantastic. Oh, I forgot something when I was talking about mascaras. I have been loving my e.l.f. mascara primer. And I know what you're saying, but you have a Dior one. Yes, and I love my Dior one. But it's a little sample, and it's really expensive to replace it to get the big size. So I tried the e.l.f. one, and oh my Lord Jesus, does this stuff work? It is, I'm not even going to show you pictures, I'm just going to link the blog post below where I talked about this and showed the comparison, and you can be the judge for yourself on whether it works or not. And then I actually got this palette for my birthday, and it's the Bare Minerals. Wait a minute, I know it. I can see what it's called. Work Weekend Wow Quad palette. And it looks like this. And it's just a little palette, nice little magnetic closure. Can go in a purse, things like that. I've really been loving doing the weekend look, which involves this really pretty pink shadow right here. And I really like it because it's gotten me into mattes, because there are 4 mattes and 3 shimmers. And they're really soft. They're not really, really, really pigmented, but they're still really nice, if you know what I mean. They're still really good. And I really like them. I like the look that it creates. Speaking of eyeshadow, I absolutely have been loving my L'Oreal Amber Rush eyeshadow, especially since I discovered that you should, to get really good pigmentation, pack it on with your finger instead of using a brush. If you want like a sheer wash of color, use a brush with this, with any of these L'Oreal Infallible eyeshadows. But if you really want an intense color, pack it on with your finger, and it, like you do with the ColourPop shadows, and it looks so amazing. Which, by the way, that's what I'm wearing today. And I never thought the day would come that I would stray from my Anastasia Brow Express kit, but I have not touched that in a month, because I have been using my It Brow Power, right? Yeah. Brow Power Brow Pencil. You know, I got this in my Ipsy bag, and it's just a really amazing brow pencil. It's like, it's perfect at feathering out the, you know, little fake hairs and just making it look wonderful. I really, really like this. Oh, never mind. I'm not even gonna count. I think this is number four. Four highlighters. But what I do different with this one, this is by City Color Cosmetics, and is their Glowing Complexion Illuminating Cream, is I mix this with my foundation, and it kind of gives you that lit from within look. And because it's getting closer to, like, fall area, you know, I want more of a lit from within look and not so much of a bronzy glow look. And so I've been mixing this more and more with my foundation, and I had forgotten how much I loved how it looked. I will definitely link the City Color Cosmetics website down below. I have been loving, of course, this cult product. The Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray is absolutely amazing. It's fantastic. It's beautiful. It's wonderful. That's done. Then I have four lip products to show you. I know, I told you guys I had a lot. And the first one is by Bella Pierre Cosmetics, and it's just this nice rosy color, not really sparkly. I mean, there's a little bit of shimmer in it, but it's not like frosty or anything. And it's just a really nice color. It is in the color P-I-N-K. That's literally what it says. It's spelled out, not like pink. It's P.I.N.K. I've really been loving this Bite Beauty lipstick duo in Fig and Date. Yes? Yes. Because on one end, you get like a really brownish nude. But on the other end, you get like more of a pinky rosy nude. And I think that's perfect, and it's beautiful, and it's wonderful, and I love it. And that's not my final product, because I have more lip products to show you. I've also really been loving my Buxom Lip Gloss in Tanya. And this is the full-on lip polish, the one that makes your lips tingle. I really, really love this. I love this. I got this at Sephora, and I love it. It's a great, it's like not super, super, super pink on the lips, but it's not like sheer either. It's that nice middle ground. And then one of the only nude colors I can wear is Nude by Gerard Cosmetics. And I love this because it's one of the only nudes I can wear without looking washed out or pale-er. And, you know, it's really nice. And if you didn't know, the Gerard Cosmetics, they, you know, come with like a light inside and a mirror and all of that. So that is not the last thing. This is the last thing. And I've been loving Vera Wang's Princess Power Perfume, which came out at Christmas. You can probably find it on eBay or maybe Amazon. But it's a really wonderful smelling perfume. It's like floral, but a deeper floral. Not a spring floral, but a deep floral. And I know that's a bit opposite in comparison as to what you should be wearing during the summer, but you know what? I liked how it smelled, and so I wore it. And I've really been wearing it a lot this month. So, that is that, and that is all she wrote, folks. That is it for my favorites. I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, please be sure to give this video a thumbs up. And if you really want to see more, be sure to hit that subscribe button. And I'm sure I can make sure you see more of these videos. I'll be seeing you guys later. Have a wonderful night. Bye.